Hey y'all, welcome back to my channel. This is Adana, also known as the AfroZen. Today I'll be reading for the water signs Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio. All right, don't forget to like and subscribe, hit the notification bell so you can keep track as to when I'm making more videos. If you would like to book a private reading or shop in my store, all that information is in the description box below. All right, so let's see. All right, I'm here for some of you guys who need to start your YouTube as of yesterday. I'm hearing start it now, okay? But they're saying start it now as of yesterday. So this is something that you've been putting off for a very long time. I'm hearing some of you guys have like stage fright or like camera fright, okay? But Spirit wants you to really step outside of the shell. And for the ones that have YouTube channels and not doing anything with it, step outside of the comfort zone and keep posting and promoting yourself, because big things are coming for you, okay? You're going through a special spiritual evolution. It's a revolution. You're evolving. Your revolution is evolving. That's what I'm hearing. You know what? I'm gonna name it that. Your revolution. Is evolving. All right, someone is going to reach out to you in regards to love. They want to confess their love to you, somebody from the past, okay? So the name of the title for this video is called Your Revolution is Evolving, right? Balance will be restored, okay? So you guys have been going through a tumultuous time when it comes to love, your love life. And just know that your balance will be restored when it comes to love, okay? Some of you guys are with your soulmates now. And if you're not with your soulmates, you're going to reconnect with them next year. Next year is 2022, which breaks it down to 6. And 6 is known for like relationships and partnerships and marriages and stuff like that. So a lot more people will be coming together with their healthy counterparts, not toxic anymore, okay? Spirit wants you to look beneath the surface. I always say this all the time. You got to stop doing surface level healing or surface level shadow work. That does not help you in any way, shape, or form, okay? So look beneath the surface. Look beneath the surface. Some of you guys are in sticky situation because I try to pull the card off of the table and there's nothing. Like, I'm literally putting my hand on the table and I don't feel any ounce of stickiness on the table. But for some odd reason, the card keeps sticking. So I feel like some of you guys are in a sticky situation when it comes to the matters of the heart. You're not able to make a decision as to what you want to do with this connection. This person has the potential to love on you, but you are afraid or you are scared that, you know, this may be too good to be true. So with this card here, Kundalini Rising, ignite your passion for life. One of your passions is being in love. You've manifested this love, but yet you're fighting the love that you created, that you manifested, okay? So be very careful of what you manifested, because it seems like you're not ready for it, and that's okay. Like I said, if you're not ready for it, don't lead them astray. Let them know how you feel. They'll wait for you, because they really see potential in you. They see potential in you and they will actually wait for you. But you got to be open and have that communication with them so that way they can know what's going on. Don't leave them in the dark as to how you're feeling, because they're very balanced emotionally. Someone is trying to lead you astray, being led astray. Okay, so you may be overindulging in something. Could be alcohol. It could be cigarettes. It could be even weed as well, too. Like you're wanting to escape from reality, okay? There's nothing wrong with escaping from reality from time to time. Just make sure you have a healthy balance with that, okay? Because it can turn into a issue or a problem where it becomes into more of the lower vibrational energy or realms, and it's going to be hard for you to get out of that, okay? And you're doing extremely well, water sign, so make sure that you don't overindulge in these activities or partake in these activities, okay? The hidden realms are here. Create conscious awareness, okay? But you won't be able to create conscious awareness if you're allowing these temptations to sneak up and get the best of you, okay? So Spirit is saying to be careful of what you are digesting or you're overindulging in. All right, so this card is in reverse, but the card says focus on a solution. So you start a lot of different things at one time, and then you're not able to finish it because you start everything at one time. So spirit is asking for you to focus on one thing at a time. Try to prioritize. You can prioritize from the most hardest to the easiest. So that way you start with the hardest things and then work your way down. And when you get to the easiest items or tasks, you'll breeze through it, or you can start from the easiest and then work your way up to the hard. However you want to do it, just find something that resonates with you, okay? But focus on a specific situation or a solution. So that way you're able to accomplish all of the goals or all the tasks that you have created for yourself, okay? Let your soul shine. So some of you guys are behind the scenes. You're not being open, okay? You're not putting out that song that you may think a lot of people don't want to hear. You're not creating that beautiful piece of work or piece of art because you feel like no one is not going to support you. You don't want to make that candle because you feel like, you know, you're not going to have the love and adoration from others, okay? Spirit is saying to let your soul shine. Who are you? Okay, there's people out here that are waiting to support you, okay? Strangers will be your best clients, will be your best customers, but they can't know who you are if you don't put yourself out there, okay? So get out from behind the scenes, get out from behind the shadows, and put yourself in the forefront so that people can see what you have to offer them, okay? You're offering them your passion because you are very passionate about this skill set, okay? I'm hearing music, so I don't know if you sing. Or you could just be using music in your candle work as well too, okay? Because I see candle work, I see this big flame of fire, super strong, but I also see air magic, but I see musical notes coming out of your mouth. So you may use music when you're manifesting, okay? Create inner harmony is here as well too. That goes back to being led astray, making sure that you're not allowing these lower vibrations or lower vibrational temptations place you in a place where you can get, you know, energetically stuck or spiritually stuck, okay? What else is going on with the water signs? Somebody about to get their back blown out this weekend. I'm talking about L-O-V-E, or like, your significant other love you. Woo, child. That energy is super strong. All right. Lovers, erotica, sensuality. So yeah, 1 + 4 breaks down to 5. So there might be some changes. Some of you guys might be getting pregnant this weekend. So be mindful if you don't want to get pregnant. Here's the actual sign messages, curiosity, and signs. All right. So this is a sign that you guys can potentially get pregnant. If you don't want that to happen, make sure you use protection. Infinite destiny magic. But I honestly feel like it's going to happen. Like, it's just going to be in the heat of the moment. And everything is just going to be like... I can't make this up. Devotion. Yeah, your significant other really love you, and they really show you that they love you in so many different ways. I mean, physically, emotionally, mentally, spiritually, but you're fighting this connection. Don't fight the connection. Good. Don't fight the connection. It's not going anywhere. Don't fight the connection. It is what you were expecting. It's not too good to be true. You've manifested this. Enjoy your manifestations. Because the universe is showing you what you've created. And the universe wants to position you in a position where you feel very comfortable with the things that you're bringing forth. Okay? Next is money. Money is coming to you. All right? You got your love. Now you're getting ready to get your money. You're going to have the best of both worlds. Okay, so you can't be like, oh, thank you, universe, for the money, but now you start eyeing the universe, like, I didn't ask for that. Yes, you did. Maybe you weren't super specific, but exactly what you said is what you received. And this person is like no other. It's someone that you normally would not even give time to, someone that you wouldn't even like pay attention to or recognize. Okay, so the universe did that on purpose. The universe did that on purpose. But it's a good fit. Stop trying to look at things. Yeah, spider and ghost card. You're trying to find things to stick. You're trying to catch somebody in a lie that don't even exist, okay? And in regards to this ghost card, once you figure out, and I say that with the air quotes, once you figure out that they're not lying, I feel like this ghost card is going to go away. But because you are so invested in them lying, because they seem like they're too good to be true, you already have your sneakers already tied up, and you're ready to just dash out because this is something that you are accustomed to, okay? But you keep creating these false narratives in your mind. Eventually, it can turn into that, all right? But I'm saying this person, it doesn't give off that energy. They give off very caring, very consistent. They show you who they are. They speak who they are. They show you in action as well too, not just words, okay? And that's the most important thing. You gotta make sure that their words are lining up with their actions. And this person has been very consistent with you since day one, and you know this. Give that person a break. This feminine energy, masculine energy, take how it resonates. Give that person a break. They are really trying with you. They're really trying. They're tired. They won't even express that to you, how, you know, sometimes you put them through the ringer, but you gotta be patient with them. And shit, I don't even want to use that word patient anymore after I find out the real term of that goddamn word. But, you know, just everything takes time, basically. If you still have to heal, have that conversation with them, they're there to help you. They're there to help you, mind, body, and soul. Okay? Let me clarify this glove real quick. Clarify this glove box. Yeah, so it's like all gloves are off, or you're wanting all gloves to be off, but you're causing an imbalance. You're causing an imbalance because it's like you're ready to fight, but there's nothing to fight. There's nothing to fight. I don't get it. What are you trying to fight? You're fighting the connection that you called in. Make that make sense? There's nothing to fight. You gotta relax. If you're not ready, say you're not ready. You'll be all right. Yeah, growth and denial. You don't want to grow, or you're having problems growing, okay? Don't be in denial about this connection. Do not be in denial about this connection. Have the courage to speak up and say how you feel. No matter how you feel, don't be afraid to have that conversation. They are very understanding, okay? You fear that your love, you fear that the love is not going to be honest. You feel like that this is not real love, and you feel like that it's not going to be honest. And I'm here to tell you that that's not true. It is very honest. It is very sincere. It is very sincere, but don't push it away because of your past connections and your past experiences. You're going to potentially mess up a great thing here. And you can't get mad, but nobody but yourself. Devotion came out a second time in a different deck. Dream, okay? Allow this person to love on you. Forgiveness. You have to forgive yourself for the part that you played in the connection from the past. This is how we learn. We can't learn if we're staying stuck in the past. It's not going to help us. All right, so that's all I have for the water signs. If it has resonated with you in any way, shape, or form, definitely feel free to like, subscribe, share, hit that notification bell. If you'd like to book a private reading with me in the store, all that information is in the description box below. So until next time, fire, or not fire. Oh, wait, no, sorry. Don't forget, or let me, my bad, I'm all over the place. Let me go ahead and pull some zodiac signs to see who's involved here with y'all. Water signs, I'm gonna pull three times. We got Capricorn here. All right, so you might be dealing with a Capricorn. You may have Capricorn in your chart. There's a Scorpio here. You might be dealing with another Scorpio. And a Gemini. Capricorn, Gemini, and Scorpio. All right, so those are the key players. This message can still resonate with you. Take it how it resonates, all right? Let me see. Spirit is saying to look in your seventh house. Look in your seventh house to see if you have any placements there. Okay, you may have some strong squares that is stopping you from accomplishing your dreams and aspirations. All right, so until next time, water signs, peace.